two free radicals will sometimes cancel each other out, frequently, usually cancel each other out. This comes from the unpaired electron language. So a free radical is an unpaired electron. Well, if you have two unpaired electrons, then they'll cancel each other out. Free radicals are not very common. So how do antioxidants fit into all this? An antioxidant is a free radical donor. So this is an example of an antioxidant, kind of a representation. This could be a vitamin C, vitamin A, one of the many vitamin E's. There's a very, very large number of antioxidants, and they take on a lot of different characteristics and behave in a lot of different ways. But the general pattern is that the antioxidant gives up a free radical. So an example would be, if we look at this, the free radical would be a hydrogen particle. So the hydrogen particle comes over and combines onto the damaged aliphatic free radical. So this would be a carbon with 7 electrons in its outer energy level, so it's unstable, very unstable. And the free radical donated by the antioxidant plugs the scar in the damaged cellular material. But free radicals never really go away. So if two free radicals can cancel each other out, if the antioxidant is going to give up a free radical, it has to become a free radical itself. So the instability that was in the damaged cellular material, that instability is now part of the antioxidant. And so there's sort of a logical error here, so that the cell consumes antioxidants. The glutathione system is designed to recharge the whole system. The whole antioxidant system is recharged with the glutathione system. So glutathione is an antioxidant like other antioxidants. Glutathione consists of a glycine amino acid, a glutamate amino acid, and a cysteine amino acid. Recall that cysteine is one of the amino acids that has a sulfur group. So we have the glycine, the glutamate, and the cysteine is the one in the middle. The sulfur group is the one we're interested in. It's the sulfur group that donates the free radical, and it's the sulfur group that takes on the instability. Sulfur is a big molecule, and the stability in the sulfur group doesn't cause any problems. So glutathione, the sulfur group of the glutathione donates a free radical, and in the process becomes a free radical itself. Just like any other antioxidant, in many ways, glutathione is a very typical antioxidant. But glutathione has a trick. I want to show it to you right here. Two glutathiones, after they've become oxidized, two glutathiones can come together and form what they call a disulfide bond. It's a very common bond in protein structure, a disulfide bond. So this is one glutathione on this side, another glutathione on this side. So this is the big tripeptide here, and this is the big tripeptide here, combined together with a disulfide bond. And then there's an enzyme, it's called glutathione reductase. Let me just write it out here. Glutathione reductase, which breaks this apart back into the original reduced active form of glutathione. So that the glutathione acts as an antioxidant, but the glutathione has a recharged system. The glutathione turns into a dimer between two of them, and then there's an enzyme that's specifically for this. And this is an uphill NADH. This is an uphill energy reaction, and it takes an NADH to push it up. So it requires energy to make this reaction happen, like many reactions in biochemistry. And And the result of this is that the glutathione can be reduced back to its active form. The significance of all this is that glutathione is the big regeneration system for all antioxidants. All antioxidants go to the glutathione system. The glutathione brings them back to life. Glutathione is the ultimate wastebasket. It's the end wastebasket for free radicals. The glutathione antioxidant system is found in vertebrates. It's found in invertebrates. It's found in plants. It's found in very nearly every type of bacteria. The antioxidant system, this is like the grandmother antioxidant system of all.